side. Hey, what's going on, everyone? Day 41. We're wrapping up some dumbbell bench press warm-ups here. Decided to go with dumbbell versus barbell, you know, just during the cut and to mix things up. So today we did 80-pound dumbbell for a 5x10. You know, when the bulk happens, whenever that is, I'll hop on over to barbell and focus on strength training. You know, for now, we're just focused on the cut and bodybuilding. But anyway, after that, did some shoulder hypertrophy, did some shrugs. Then some dumbbell overhead press, high-low rows for the rear delt, and then finished off with lateral raises and external rotations. It was a fun day, but yeah, let's hop into it. Thank you guys so much for being here.
Yo, what's going on, everyone? Today we got chest and shoulder hypertrophy. You know, since we're cutting, I thought it'd be a good idea to kind of start doing some incline, or sorry, some flat dumbbell press, and kind of ditch the barbell press for a while. Just give me a break too, you know what I mean? I'm here to bodybuild, not powerlift. So I've not done, I got pre-workout on my lips. I've not done a dumbbell press in years. So don't know what to expect, but it's gonna be a sick day. I got 80s here and gonna go for a 5x8. Or how many is, if, you know what? If I stop at 8 and it feels pretty good, we'll go up some. I've not done dumbbell flat press in, gosh, 8 years. It's been a while. Let's get the same way. Yo, I'm not gonna try to pick him up off the floor again. That was 10. Let's do a, yeah, let's keep the same weight. I'm not doing a 5x10 today. I'm just gonna keep the same weight. Let's do 80s. Let's do a 5x10 with it. I don't wanna go up and wait and then not be able to get an 8 and then cook the rest of my sets, you know? But yeah, not bad. It's been a while since I've done dumbbell press, so I'm happy with the 80s today.
I got it.
Thanks, dude. Whew. Yeah, that was perfect. 3 more sets. He's still good, man. 3 more sets. Yeah. what's up. Whew. Two more sets. Oh, that's heavy. That was perfect.
Good job, dude.
Two more sets. So, like, why am I doing this? So, you know, bench press, I've been doing that for today makes 8 months. Today's February 1st, right? That's how I mixed up. And plus, you know, eating in a deficit, it's going to be hard to make progressions on, like, compounds like a bench. I mean, everything else I feel like is still going pretty good, but bench I've been hard stuck for a few weeks. So I figured, you know, on the cut, I could do dumbbells, kind of work on the imbalances, you know what I mean? Focus on the stretch and the squeeze, because I'm not trying to power lift, too, and I got to remember that. But then when I start bulking again, we'll hop back over. We're not done with bench press. When I start bulking again, we'll hop back on the barbell and progress from there. But yeah, thank you guys so much for being here. Day 41. I weighed 230 today. It's all water. Only 20 more pounds to go.
I got it.
One more set. Last set. After this, we're going to do some shoulder hypertrophy. We're not going to do the iso press. I'm trying to eliminate some stuff that's making my shoulder click and my neck hurt, so we're not going to do the seated barbell anymore. We're going to do standing, but that's next week. But today we're going to do the just dumbbell shoulder press. I think the iso press is kind of tweaking me out too, but or I keep saying it. Maybe I'm just getting old. I'm cooked. That was good though. 38 reps, so 37 because last set I only got 9.2. All right, perfect. Let's do some shoulder press. I need a couple minutes though, then we'll do it. Shrugs. Let's give the front delts a break. We'll do some dumbbell shoulder press after this, but let's do some shrugs. We're gonna keep the same weight. Last week we got this for 12, I think. Just gonna do as many as I can for 4 sets. Really, you know, I talk about this every week. Don't pull up to your ears. Squeeze your shoulder blades together in the back. You know, I like to stick my neck out, lean forward a little bit, and just really squeeze as hard as I can. And then focus on the stretch too on the way down. Thank you. That sucks with a neck stinger, dude. All right. Three more sets. Yo, I didn't even talk about it. So all of my carb intake was like before 2 p.m. And I was so hungry. Like last night, I was starving. I might have talked about it. I don't know. I'm going crazy. But I did not sleep good last night, but I was so hungry last night. You know, we made that cornbread the night before. It took a lot of willpower to not just go to town on that last night before bed. But I'll get used to it. Those are, dude, S tier, this machine. S tier. All right, 2 sets. I had to cut out the cluster dextrin today just so I could have some more carbs later. But I still had like 90 grams of carbs this morning. No, I think it was 110. Had my, you know, my protein too. Gosh, I'm sweaty. Dude, they turn the heat up in here. Why aren't you sweating like this? You're not intense like me.
Yeah, how much cardio did you do this morning, Justin?
I don't want to talk about it. None. None, okay? I slept in. I'm not perfect. Pretty close, though. What's up, guys? 41. 41 days you guys have been hanging out with me. Thank you so much. My music will play, bro. Shrugs are done, buddy. I got lightheaded. Dude, why do mirrors lie so much? When I'm looking at the mirror, I'm like, I have a nice chest. But then when I watch the videos, I'm like, I have boobs, man. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Yeah, the camera's keeping me humble for sure. Just some shoulder press with dumbbells. Alright, so we got some dumbbell overhead press. So I got 60s. Got the bench on like a slight incline. You know, I'm just gonna see how it feels. I might go more steep on the slope on the next set, depending on how this feels. But Cody just did a set, said he really liked it. Just again, I'm just trying to mix things up, try to figure out why my shoulders started clicking, and try to prevent getting another stinger in my neck. It's always after I do shoulders. Figure this out. I got 60s here, don't know what to expect. But let's do four sets of this. That was pretty good. Do I go all the way up like this, or do I just go like?
That's what I'm doing, I guess. I'm trying to do like full range of motion.
So you're going up like this?
Yeah, I'm trying to.
All right, I'll do that, because I did like the first four like that. I think I did that 9. I like this angle, I'm gonna keep it. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, let's do 3 more sets like that. That's kind of a trial and error, you know what I'm saying? Let's do 3 more. Let's do 3 more sets, it feels really good. Yeah, I was thinking, I'm curious to hear what you guys say. I was thinking where I was kind of up, and I was kind of torquing my back a little bit. You know what I mean? Try to, I don't know, I'm just playing with some stuff. I don't want you guys to think it hurts. I mean, the stinger hurts, but my shoulders don't. They're starting to click. Man, let's get heavy quick. Ah, 2 more sets. This feels good though. No discomfort. All right, 2 more sets. Oh, no discomfort. So let's see if we stick with this for a few weeks. I got a pretty good side delt pump too. I'm definitely activating my upper pec, which is fine, but I feel most of the weight in my front delt and my side delt, which is what I'm going for. Oh my goodness. There we go. It's always the 9th one, dude. I cruised until like 6 or 7. Oh, that was good. One more set. One more set. I'm thinking like, do some lateral raises. You want to do lateral raises or the high to low? Next. Okay. Anyway. The 9th one every time. No discomfort though. I mean, it's hard to tell. It's my first day doing that, but they feel really good. No concerns with that at all. All right, let's do something else. All right, let's do some rear delt work. High to low, I really liked this last time. Just remember, anytime that your arms are next to your side or even a 45 degree angle and you're pulling through to your chest, you're gonna activate your rear delt a lot. So, I mean, this will do it for sure. I mean, I could talk a little bro science here. It's proven that when your arms are to your side or at a 45 degree angle, you can really get some activation back there. So that's kind of what I'm focused on this. Kept the same weight as last week, 45 and a 25 pound plate on each side. I'm just gonna squeeze, man. Go to failure, do this 3 sets. S tier, buddy. Dude, like, I have, like, the straps help, but I have, like, almost my fingers pointing up like this. And it really, like, almost like a neutral grip. Really sweet. Dude, it's so, so sick. Let's do two more sets like that. Let's just take, like, a minute rest and keep hitting it. All right. Oh, Cody's stupid. And you guys like him more than me. He's so stupid. He almost got like a trigger finger. I don't know, man. That little tweak is helping me squeeze him. I can't, like, I'm like this. Dude, it's so sick. Dude, they're like, that's so sick, man. The reason, like, I like these two, Cody, it's so hard to get, like, heavy weight for your rear delts. And, like, you can, like, really load this up. You know what I mean? I don't know. Like, the side rotations are good. The face pulls are good, but you can't really do a lot of weight. Oh. They were, like, they're pumped. That's sick. Let's do one more set. All right, last set. These are so good, dude. I know you can't really see. I'll stop at the on the bottom. But, like, see my fingers? I'm like, it's allowing me to have, like, more of a neutral grip, which is allowing my elbows to get closer to my side. I mean, I know not everyone's gonna have this machine. Dude, they're done. They're done. I'm not even gonna do. Yeah, I'm still gonna do side external rotations. Just two sets like I did last week. Rear delts are pretty cooked after that. Alright, let's do some side lateral raises. I'm really focused on turning my hands down. And which is gonna put a lot of emphasis on my side delt. Like almost like pouring like a tall glass of milk or something. It's a pretty bad analogy, you know what I'm saying? Dang. Try to go up in weight this week. I'm gonna get some lighter dumbbells. That was pretty heavy. One thing I've been really focused on is the scapular plane. So instead of coming out to my side, I'm more in front like a 45 degree. Turning my wrist down like this, I'm just really gonna focus all that weight on my side delt. Scapular plane, out in front like this. Try it. Yeah. One more set. I had to take the sweatpants off. I was burning up. Oh, I swear they turned the heat up in here. Let's go do something else. Whew. Let's do some external rotations. Doing a superset with the 45 pound plate shrugs. Should have grabbed the plates. I'll go get them. I'll be right back. So I'm doing this for the road hinder cuff work, and it's also working my rear delts. Keeping my elbow to the side and really squeezing outwards. Just can't load up a lot of weight. That's why I like the high to low, because I can load them up, you know? Put some mass on them. But, you know, with the shoulder clicking, I really want to focus on my shoulder joint health. I miss being young. Stretch down. Let's go. Let's do one more set and we'll get out of here. I'm getting hungry. I'm excited to have some carbs. Last set, studio. Shirt's coming off today. That's it. It's done. See you guys in the studio. It's done. Dumbbell bench press. Dude, that was sick. That squeeze, man, that stretch and the squeeze, and I think it's really going to fix my balances. You know, I briefly talked about it. I think it's, you know, not that it's silly, right? It's still getting work in, but I think I need to focus on bench press when we hit the bulk again and really eating in the surplus and really focus on strength right now. You know, I'm just bodybuilding, just trying to lean out. I mean, I'll still focus on progressing. Like next week, I'll try to do, you know, a 5x10. You know, we almost did a 5x10 today, but that fourth set we did 9 and the fifth set we did 8. But I'll stick with 80s until we can do like 12 to 15 times, and then we'll bump it up. You know what I mean? Because I'll definitely get stronger as the more I do it. But it felt good. First time I've done that in, like 8 years. Because when I first started coming back to the gym, you know, 8 months ago today, it's just all been barbell. Which is fun because, you know, it was a rapid growth. I went from 135 for four to 225 for five. So it was kind of hard to stop. But since I'm eating in a deficit, you know, the strength progressions on all my compounds, even though a lot of them are still going up, but I mean, they're gonna plateau or kind of stop, you know, but focus on bar. I mean, I'm still gonna do all my other compounds except the barbell overhead press and the barbell bench press. Still gonna do deadlifts and squats and some pull-ups. Pull-ups should go up pretty quick, so that's gonna be fun. But focus more on, you know, progressive overloading or strength training when I start eating the bulk, you know, whenever that's gonna be. I don't know if I'm gonna try to cut, you know, it'd be nice to cut like 15% body fat, but that's gonna take a long time. We're just gonna, you know, we're not gonna rush it. We're just gonna eat in a deficit a little bit at a time, you know, 2,700 to 2,900 calories and just see how much body fat I can lose. But yeah, enough yapping, take the shirt off. The shoulder day was awesome. I swear, dude, that's so hot in there. Today's the first day I took the sweats off without like doing a leg pose. Like it was so hot, man. I don't know, dude. I think like it started to warm up outside. You know, today was like 49 this morning. I still feel like they got the heat on, you know, like it was when it was like in the negatives. There, we all had that cold spell, but I'm feeling like look at that. I'm feeling leaner. I don't know, I probably look exactly the same, but I keep yapping without my microphone on. I'm feeling leaner for sure. I probably look exactly the same. Let's see, we did some shoulders, so let's do back double by. Do one of these. Definitely feeling lean today, for sure. Fun day, man. That's it. See you guys in the truck. Day 41. Yo, I am hungry. So hungry. Dude, am I crazy or did I look lean with my shirt off? Maybe I just didn't feel so bloated. Cut my carb. You know, I want to eat most of my carbs in the morning. But I think until I get used to the deficit a little bit, I don't want to ease into it. I'm fully committed on my macro goals. But I think until I get used to it, eating at, you know, the slight caloric deficit, I'm going to lower my carbs in the morning. That way I can have some in the evening. You know what I mean? I mean, it's affecting my workout a little bit, I guess. You could argue, but I talked about this yesterday. I think being intense is all, what kind of mentality you have. I mean, sure, you and you know, you could definitely argue. Dang, this, what up, fam? This thing is like, I don't know. I thought I had it tight. So I have like a windshield mount for my phone. I mean, it wasn't hard to figure out, but it's like getting all wobbly today. But yeah, being intense is like mostly mental, in my opinion. But I mean, you can't argue the fact that if you're depleted, you're going to be exhausted. I'm not worried about my strength and stuff going down. I'm worried about the endurance and stuff hitting me. But in theory, when I lose weight and get more trim, have less body fat, my endurance should go up as well. So I think there's a fair trade off of that. If I'm making sense. Dude, the traffic is insane. But just so I'm not like struggling, dude, I'm serious. It took everything in me to not like eat that cornbread last night. I was like, you gotta commit. You promised you'd commit. And then, you know, not that I've been eating at a crazy surplus, but I've been eating maintenance, you know. I've been eating a lot more than I have been the past 2 days. So it's just gonna, you know, a week or so, I'll get used to it. And I know I will, because for years, dude, you know, I was a big Hodge Twins fan back in the day when I was, you know, pretty lean out, when I was leaned out a lot. I was like 190, pretty, I have to find a picture. I'll post it right now. Boop. I mean, I was a youngin. That was like 7-8 years ago. You know, so I was like 25. But I look like a kid. But, you know, I was really big into Hodge Twins, and they influenced me to, like, intermittent fast. And I didn't eat. I probably had, like, excuse me. I was probably eating, like, 175 grams of protein. And I wasn't really, I wasn't tracking, that's for sure. But I was only eating one meal a day, and it was a lot of protein. And I tried to smash some, you know, some carbs. I remember the video, I'll never forget, where they'd sit down and eat like a whole pan of cornbread, you know, stuff like that. I wasn't really tracking it because I believe back in the day, like, you lose weight even if you just ate once a day. You know what I'm saying? Don't worry about it, just founder, you know. But at the same time, I was also playing basketball and stuff. What I'm getting at is, like, I'd go 16 hours a day. Okay, I was 25, right? But I would go 16 hours a day without eating at anything. You know, I would drink coffee and water. And I would go lifted, fasted. And then I'd go home and eat. But some days, dude, I would go lifted, fasted. And, like, intense, like I am now, probably way more volume. I was actually doing, like, the pyramid. Like, I don't know if you call it ladder or pyramid. It wasn't really a pyramid. It was more of a ladder. So I would do a set, up the weight up. Do a set, up the weight up. I'd do four sets on everything like that. And then after that, I go play basketball and run around, you know, point guard. Like, run around like a madman. You talk about sweat now. You should have seen me, you know, back in the day. Those guys, that's probably why I scored so many points, because no one wanted to guard me because I was disgusting. But, you know, I'm just yapping about, you know, your mentality and just being intense, you know. Your diet could be on point for sure, but if you're not intense in the gym or in your training, then it's not going to really do anything, you know. Just be intense and consistent, man. I talk about that all the time. I know a lot of y'all don't believe in my split, and that's fine. I don't believe in your split. I do, you know, but I'm doing what's fun. It's all about fun, man. Whether, you know, I think CrossFit is silly. No offense to anyone that does CrossFit, but some of those pull-ups look like momentum pull-ups to me, you know. I don't know what the hell is going on, but CrossFit people are yoked too, man. Powerlifters are yoked. Gymnasts. I keep talking about gymnasts. Gymnasts have the biggest arms on the planet, dude. Go look at an Olympic gymnast and tell me that they are not just jacked, because they all are, you know. It doesn't matter what you do, man. As long as you're intense and consistent, don't get lost in the sauce, man. Sure, I won't argue that there's something that's going to give you an advantage quicker, but I would argue it's microscopic. And what does it matter, dude? Why do something that's not fun? You know, this isn't the split I'm doing forever. I guarantee there'll be a day where I do a PPL. I guarantee there'll be a day where I do full body. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, I want to mix it up, and variety's good, but I'm doing what's fun. You know what I mean? I appreciate the feedback, and, you know, I do a lot of things that you guys suggest, like different forms, different lifts, you know, diet. I even bought some of that HMB powder because it's supposed to help, like, prevent, like, you know, the catabolic state of your muscles, you know, when you're eating in a deficit, is what I read. I'm like, I'll try anything, but at the end of the day, I'm going to do what's fun. And you guys should too. Like, I try to influence, I feel like what I influence a lot is, like, having fun and being consistent. But if we're talking about, like, the bro stuff I influence on is form. I'll never be like, you guys should be eating this. You guys should be working out 6 days a week. You know what I'm saying? I will never, ever be that type of content creator, because, like, pardon my language, I don't give a fuck what you guys do. Like, just have fun, man. You know what I mean? Just have fun. Anyway, I'm in a preachy mood. I just had a really good day, and I'm so hungry. Go home, eat some white rice. I ate so much meat last night. I'm not complaining. So I got this, I think this spice brand is called Spiceology. But Cody got me this container of, it's called Eruption. It's barbecue rub. Dude, I threw that, because so typically, when I was eating maintenance, when I'd eat salmon, I'd sprinkle olive oil and Parmesan cheese and minced garlic on my salmon and bake it. But yesterday, I threw that Eruption on it because it's, like, no calories, or it's very little calories. And it was so good. And then the sirloin, I did the same thing with the sirloin. I seared it with that on there. I really, really like that stuff. But he like puts it on his eggs and everything. I'm not put it on eggs yet. Maybe I'll try that. I didn't have time to eat eggs this morning. I kind of slept in a little bit. I was feeling a little rushed, so my morning diet wasn't the best. I got the Fit milk, which is low in fat. It's got a little too much carbs, but I'm really liking that Dairy Gold Fit chocolate milk a lot. And then I know you guys have been seeing me eating the mini toast, the Cinnamon Toast Crunch, the mini ones. But it's rice flour. And there is some sugar. I think there's like per serving, there's 31 grams of carbs and like 9 grams of sugar, which is a lot. But, you know, I'm going to do, it's just like my lifting program. I'm going to do a diet that helps me stay consistent. I'm if it fits your macros kind of guy, you know. But I would still argue, other than the cereal, man, the only treat I have all week is that donut on deadlift day. And I'm still gonna make room for that. But what I wanna start doing, I mean, I know I shouldn't eat Cinnamon Toast Crunch, I admit. I like it though. I gotta find a cereal that's a little bit better for me and less sugar than that. So the Raisin Bran I was messing with for a while, but it's just got a lot of fiber. Fiber's fine, but when you guys are tracking carbs, make sure that you're paying attention to how much fiber is in it, because that's insoluble. Your body's not digesting that. You're pooping it straight out. I think fiber's great because it helps combat the potent protein farts, and you know, it helps solidify your stool that's coming out. But just make sure when you guys are eating fiber, make sure you're deducting it from your overall carb intake. You know what I mean? I mean, you don't have to get lost in the sauce, but that's just some things to think about. So I kind of cut the Raisin Bran because my fiber was going up. And the reason why I was eating the more fiber, too, is because I had some pretty bad pooping problems, but it ended up being that pre-gym. Which I like the pre-gym, but just my stomach didn't agree with it. And I cut that out. Things have been going better. Thank God I'm not lactose intolerant, because that would have sucked. That would have sucked a lot, because I'll admit, a lot of my protein intake is milk and whey concentrate and stuff like that. But anyway, I'm talking in circles. I want to get some Chex or some Rice Krispie cereal for the rice flour versus like the wheat, you know, with the high in fiber. So I think this weekend I gotta go to Costco either today or tomorrow. I'm gonna load up on some Rice Krispie cereal. If they have it, I'm sure they do. Either that or Chex. Cause it's rice flour as well. Lots of rice, man. I've not had hardly any pasta since I've been tracking my macros. Which is fine. I don't mind rice, dude. You know, I put some low sodium oh my goodness. Soy sauce. Dude. Brain fart, man. Maybe I got brain fog for not eating as much. But low sodium soy sauce in it. I got to buy, you know what I got to buy too, since I'm eating in a deficit? It's some sugar-free barbecue sauce too, to dip the chicken and stuff in. I can't just eat dry chicken. I mean, I can, but I prefer a little sauce action with it too, you know. But anyway, enough yapping. Today was fun. I really like the dumbbells for now, because we're eating in a deficit versus, I should have talked about this when I first got in the truck, but you know, we're eating in a deficit, so, and we're doing this to bodybuild, not powerlift, so focus on working those imbalances, stretch and contraction. 80 pound dumbbells I was ecstatic with. Did that was way more than I expected, so the strength is there. And we'll just keep doing that, man, and then bulk, we'll go back to the barbell press. But and the shoulders, I really like the incline bench for that. It might have been a little too flat, and I was kind of hitting my upper chest, but the shoulder, I had a good shoulder pump, and no discomfort at all. It felt great. So we'll stick with that. Shrugs, King. The high to low is S tier. That's my favorite. As of now, it's my favorite shoulder exercise. Just try to keep the neutral grip if you can, and keep your elbows tucked into your side, and really squeeze that rear delt on the way down. You know, pull to your chest. Don't lean back. Pull to your chest. But yeah, and then the external rotations for the shoulder joint health, and spam some plated shrugs. But yeah, go home. Like I'm gonna preach this always, man. You know, do what you want. You know, diet, whatever. Just make sure that you're hitting your macros, staying consistent, and you're resting and hydrating. Tomorrow we got arm day, my favorite day. So looking forward to that. I mean, I look forward to every day, but arm day is king. Arm day is king. But all love. Thank you guys so much for the support and all the feedback and comments and the likes and stuff. I really appreciate it so much. We're going to keep this thing rolling, man. Happy day 41. I'll see you guys tomorrow for day 42. Peace out.